Okay. That seems pretty cool. Oh. Yeah, it's been a long time. Oh, family game.
In my experience, the team really tried to develop a game that allowed people to work together, to play together, whether it was friends.
Yeah, they're not going to win Game of the Year.
And for me, my personal
experience, I swear, if Baldur's Gate does not win it, we're going to have
an empire, a kingdom in distress from the evil likes of Bowser. Whether you're playing as Elephant Mario, Peach, Yoshi, or Nabbit, this game goes to everyone that created such a wonderful experience.
World premieres in a row.
Let's see. USB. This. Asperge. Among Us. Among Us. The Rise of the Golden Idol. I have a buffer as well. So, if it's one thing, is this? It looks like the garden game from Microsoft. Grounded, what was it called? Finji. In collaboration with Sweet Baby Incorporated. This looks okay.
Dangerous heretics, vile mutants, and Xenos threats beyond number.
Who is this? Warhammer? Is this the studio by... No, I don't think this is the studio with Dave. Oh, using sound language. Oh, this might be a cool game. If they can teach you... If it has the ability to improve people's sign language skills. It seems like it takes two. Or grounded from its onset. It seems cool. That's what it is. It seems cool.
Honestly, I don't know how much better gaming can get. What happens past a golden age? Platinum? Is this the platinum age of gaming? Also, can I please be paid in platinum? I'd like it direct deposited, please. And now I have the honor of announcing the winners for our 5 esports categories. The nominees for best esports athlete are Faker, Zywoo, Demon One, Hydra, Ruler, and Imperial Hal. And the game award goes to Faker. For best esports coach, the nominees are Potter, Zonic, Gunba, Ecstasy, and Homie. And the game award goes to Potter. For best esports event, here are the nominees. 2023 League of Legends World Championship, Blast TV Paris Major 2023, EVO 2023, the International Dota 2 Championships 2023, and Valorant Champions 2023.
Why is there a war for
and
best esports event?
To
why?
2023 League of Legends World Championship.
Like, literally, why is there a war
for
best
esports
event?
Game, the nominees
I understand that one.
Why
event?
Dota 2. League
story about a world very different from ours.
It's a world where all
Kingdom Hearts? Kingdom Hearts? You better be Kingdom Hearts or I'm gonna riot.
To put it another way, this is a fantasy.
Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom, let's go. It's Kingdom Hearts. It's Kingdom Hearts. No, it's Atlas.
The fortress at the border was raised by a human mere days ago. You can only blame your king's weakness. Who deserves his crown?
Hey.
Proven strength.
The people of my land desire a new king, and I shall provide.
Welcome one and all to the inauguration of the tournament for the throne.
Small wonder when any among the populace might be king.
Their speeches of tribal harmony mean nothing. When every day they cheat and abuse us.
It tells of a world.
This actually looks epic.
Tribe.
If only our lives were anything like the world in the novel.
Our lives are decided at birth by tribal purity, or by the differences that make us who we are.
There was a plot in his life. One I wish I'd written out sooner.
So, am I running this at 4K? It's running 4K now.
You'll be a hero. Trust me.
Tonight,
I don't think they're gonna win.
The industry's greatest
game of the war.
Game
of the year.
Mark Cerny, PlayStation's lead system architect, celebrating 25 years of Cerny Games. Thank you for being here, Mark.
Why is Mark Cerny here?
Of course, the team behind Pizza Towers here too.
Why is Mark Cerny here?
Everyone's
usually
here.
To the come.
Melina Jurgens, our best performance winner.
Net 3, baby.
For Hellblade.
Go.
Welcome. I think we'll be seeing
Net 3.
You a little bit later.
Net 3 is coming.
I have such great memories of last year, Mr. Pacino. Forgetting to thank my wife. Mother. I get it. I'm not gonna stand up here making long speeches. I'm gonna stick to the script. No 8-minute speech like last year. But fun fact, my speech was actually longer than this year's Call of Duty campaign. What?
Shots fired.
Another company I'll never work for. I'm here to present the award for best performance in a year of games, beloved by audiences and acclaimed by critics. These actors delivered 6 unforgettable performances. And here are the nominees.
Best performance.
Revenge. I'm actually crying. Is a weapon.
It's been a long 5 years.
Hope maybe. Who do I think will win? Oh, then now they have security. Now they have security. They're not fucking around this time.
Hi. This is unreal. I just wanted to say, I know I don't have much time. Well, I'll give it a shot.
Congratulations, Neil. Great speech. And short, so thank you. There are lots more awards to come, but now it's time to look ahead to what you'll be playing next. Let's get...
Yay.
Let's see.
When the Archetype team first reached out to me, I was excited about...
Don't be mobile.
What really turned
no
me
mobile.
On was when they shared the game's vision and my role in it. I will be voicing a character in this game, and all I can say is that I will have a unique relationship with every player. In this game, time moves differently. Days for you are decades for your loved ones back home. The choices that you make not only affect the people that you love, they'll also affect your entire civilization for generations to come. Now, personally, I have had some experience with time dilation. And now you can too. So now I am proud to share the first ever look at Exodus.
Okay, it's actually 3D. And not doesn't feel like an indie game. Well, let's see the gameplay.
We need to head back.
Hold on, I'm getting a reading.
Max!
What?
What she found that day was a miracle. It would be our salvation. To fight against the Celestials. Humanity's greatest enemy.
This is it.
They found us.
Tom, stay down!
The Celestials hunted us down. I knew they'd keep chasing us until they ripped our ship apart. And I had to save her. I led them away from this world, away from her. We both knew the cost of using the gates. When you travel at light speed, time slows to a crawl. It was only days for me, but an entire lifetime passed for her. And in the chaos of those final moments, we never said goodbye.
No, come with me! Wait! Please, Tom! I love you.
Our service, our sacrifice, discovers worlds, seeds hope, breaks empires. We are the travelers.
Oh.
Is a very exciting project, cool. Giving me some Mass Effect vibes, and I appreciate the team sharing the first glimpse of gameplay at the end there.
Mass Effect?
Looks great. All right, well, now we're going to go right on to another world premiere.
Kratos. Gotta work. 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 Gotta work.
Nothing that would help us.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Driver.
Must face this.
I'm not the crack.
No shame in what just happened. It's all part of the process.
Arena. Valhalla. What the fuck? Free DLC? Oh my.
There's a very nice holiday surprise from PlayStation. Kratos and Mimir are headed to Valhalla in an adventure that blends God of War Ragnarok's combat with elements inspired by the roguelike genre for an emotional, unexpected, and fun new twist. And yes, as you saw, it is free. The team at Santa Monica Studio are fans of their fans and are offering this DLC, God of War Ragnarok Valhalla, as a gift to the community, and you will be able to download it in just 5 days on December 12th. Amazing. All right, switching
gears. Fucking go.
Our next world premiere comes from a small independent team of developers in Australia. I love that this show can give a platform to independent creators. Their last game in 2019 was a sensation, and their next project is equally exciting and unexpected.
You hear that? My heart rate. My heart rate is up. Let's fucking go. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You have to follow up with that. I'm really sorry. You're dead. You can't follow up with that. I'm sorry.
Ooh, there they are.
Where? Oh, I see them.
Let's go.
Now, this would be a perfect night if they actually show some snippets of Dragon Age gameplay. Even though it's for the small season, just give me a gameplay teaser. And I'm good. It'll be 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10 for me. For this.
It awaits me.
I don't think Final Fantasy 16 is going to win anything in this game war. Maybe Marvel.
And the award goes to... Alan Wake 2.
Oh!
Ah, thank you so much.
I was flabbergasted.
Alan Wake.
I really don't think.
So Gonzo, what have you been playing?
Oh, that old stick.
Seriously, what have you been playing?
debut indie game. Sea of Stars. I never heard of this game. Dredge, and never heard of it. Pizza Tower. Limbo. Viewfinder. Maybe Viewfinder.
Alright, the great Gonzo. Thank you, Gonzo. And now to the task at hand. The game award goes to Cocoon.
I saw a Pizza Tower. Not Pizza Tower, Viewfinder. But I didn't play it. I watched Smitty play through it. It was an interesting game. A very interesting concept. Do I go on Kakarot? Or is it the last part of the season pass? Oh, Budokai Tenkaichi 4. Oh! Bro. Tremble before my power. I'll show you the horrors of hell. Now perish along with this dragon. Parking Zero. Dragon Quest. Oh my god, it looks beautiful. Can we? No Room Factory? Uphold the legacy now and for always. The Secret of Mana? Secret of Mana. There we go, the Secret of Mana. Yep, this is Secret of Mana. Oh! Is this a remake? Visions of Mana. What can I say? It looks very on point. It's probably going to be fun and interesting, but it's not that much of a game. I'm like, it's probably gonna be fun, probably gonna be cool. But I'm probably not gonna play it at launch. It feels that type of sort of game. Oh, this looks interesting. USB. Oh my fucking god. Fuck off. Just for that, I'm gonna buy some nicotine. Oh yeah, this game I'm probably interested in. Show us. Every story begins at the end of another. Each story carries with it the echoes. One thing I like about EA Origins, they're very high class in picking which indie game to support. It's basically like they're very draconian. It looks very good. I'm gonna pick it up.
Well, you know what they say.
A retouch. I remember it wasn't that light. There's not enough details. Todd Howard. Light, no fire.
Welcome, my friends, to Mysidia.
Mysidia, the land of the mages. Echoes of falling on the rising tide. Why today? Oh! Bruh. When did he bring up that? When did he take that out? When did he take that out? I don't know. Oh my dear, it was like a... The flute guy, on point.